a second.
It's supposed to be all the same speed.
So everyone wins?
No, it's just whoever's a better driver wins.
Motorcycle language. Screamish.
Thank you.
are at the racetrack with our second place runner this tonight. And so how tonight go?
It started out pretty lumpy, actually. The heat race didn't go well. I couldn't shift my engine, and I ended up having to bail out. Did a little bit of work to the car, got it into the gear that I needed, and just went out and pretty much got it done for the future.
Got it done. You avoided all the big holes.
The big holes, that's correct. And I made it from start to finish without any major problems.
There you go. So, yeah, because I heard the track was a little bit rough in three and four.
Three and four was a little bit rough. However, I tried to play that to my advantage where I'd sink a tire in there and it would pull me around the corner. So it actually helped me out. It did, yeah.
There you go.
So, you know, if you play it right, a lot of times the obstacles help you out.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad someone worked at their advantage. Everybody else is complaining about white and stupid legs. They could hurt their cars.
Well, just remember, we all have that disadvantage. Right? Yeah. All the cars get the same track.
We're all the same track. Yeah, we're all around the same track.
Same obstacles.
There you go. So, you're all set for next week?
Yeah.
Next week's a big weekend.
Well, it's a big weekend, but I'm going to try to get the car to shift. That would be helpful.
Oh, yeah, that would be good.
Yeah, and otherwise, I'm just going to fix it in third gear and give it another shot. That's going to be it.
We got the Lenny West Memorial Race.
Yes, we do.
Which is both places.
Yes, it's usually a very eventful weekend. I know we're going to have a lot of fun on Saturday. We're going to probably have a barbecue and just have a good time as a group. Have a fun weekend. I'm quite sure Lenny will be happy with it. We've done with the club and, you know, what he created.
Yeah, that's what I do. Roll numbers and make it bigger and have a little fun.
Absolutely, my friend.
All right, thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, we're here after the race here. We came in first, second, third. We're going to talk about the race in a little bit, and then we're going to talk to Zach at the end here, get some background. So, Tony. Obviously, yeah. The race must have went pretty well.
It went very good. My car was hooked up nice. And you had given me some pointers last week that I put into effect, and the car went nice.
I'm going to give you some pointers. You did well.
And you said last week how you never had a win. So, I mean, obviously, this is going the right direction.
Definitely.
There you go. All right, Dick, how'd the race go for you?
It was good. I was surprised. Me had never won. I've won some races over the years, but not me.
I'll figure it out.
But if I'm going to get beat, I'm glad it was this guy right here. He runs everybody clean.
It's always next week, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's always next week. You can get him the dirt next week.
I did 2 weeks ago.
There you go. See? Every week's a new week.
Yeah.
Zach, how'd it go for you?
Pretty good. It was my first time back in the car in probably 4 years. Way back. It felt good. It was nice and rough.
But, track was a little rough?
Tried a couple of different lines and got my feet wet, spun out a couple of times, brought out the caution. It happens. I'm glad it went as good as it did. Got a couple of adjustments to make, and then these two are probably going to have to shake me off the back.
Let's hope so, right? That's the idea. It's supposed to be fun. All fun racing.
That's what it's all about. I had more fun tonight than I did 10 years ago.
Trophies and bragging rights. That's the whole idea.
I don't even have one. I gave it to the owner.
Well,
I got to thank Rick and Terry Baller for, you know, shooting me a text saying, hey, when you want to set the car up, and definitely caught me off guard. So I'm glad that I was able to get the car.
There you go. Well, that's good. Obviously, because obviously, it's another car on the track, and hopefully, we can get a few more. Because obviously, the 600 feet, two more cars. Third place runner. We're going to get some background on him. Obviously, you talked about you ran in with the mini sprints before.
Yep.
What year was that?
I got into it, hooked up with Troy in 2008, and set me up with an old asphalt tire called Pinky that sat in the corner of the garage and looked like it needed a home. So worked out a deal with him, picked that up, ran 2009, took Rookie of the Year, top contender with Casey Hansen and Josh Boston. Troy and a couple other people, pretty much top three every week for the whole season. And, you know, stripped it all down, and then got offered to sell it the following year. Now somebody else in the club has it. I didn't miss it then, but tonight I missed it.
Well, you're back. Obviously, you raced it tonight. Yeah. Hopefully, is the owners looking for you to race the rest of the season?
Rick Ball over here. We do hill climb racing and Beyonce do hill drags and flat drags. And, you know, so I got to know Rick over the years, and, you know, he knows that. He knows I can go in circles. I can go in a couple circles in one lap, but it was cool. He shot me a text and said, when you want to set the car up? I thought he texted somebody else.
Obviously, it worked out. You obviously shot one back, so you're going to talk about
it.
Well, that's good. So, what do you do with your full time job?
I was working at Little Mountain. Wrench and heavy duty equipment and stuff. And job opportunity came up to go drive a truck to deliver some booze, liquor and wine, and thought maybe I'd dabble in that, and I love it. It's good, hard work. I'm just happy.
Whereabouts do you live?
I live right in Bristol, New Hampshire, right down off Newfoundland.
So you're pretty close to tracks then.
That's good.
That works out for you. Obviously, a lot of people travel some distances to get to some of these places, myself.
Yeah. I like the countryside. Deliver down to Manchester and Nashua, and I scratch my head. I'm like, how do these people do it?
Yeah, that's for sure. All right, well, nice meeting you. And definitely, hopefully we'll see you next week. And be back on the podium. That would be good.
Yeah, we'll make some changes and definitely look into getting these guys up. We run with some good guys. And that's the biggest thing, is just to go and have fun. And just finish them.
There you go.
Yep.
Come back the following week. That's always a good thing.
Yep.
Tip from upside down, cross mine.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, great.
Thank you very much.
All right, here I am at the Legion Speedway with Ed Vickery. I'm going to interview him for the mini sprints, the 500cc mini sprints. He's the driver of what number are you?
48.
The 48. Okay, Ed, how'd you get into this mini sprint racing?
My father helped start working with the club back in 83 and 84. I got involved. Background 96 to 2001, 2002. I went up to 750s, ran down Room City at 750s for a while. And then I wound up taking a little bit of hiatus off. I bought a house and run my own business and stuff like that. So kind of, you know, took some time off. And then last year, a good friend of mine, Troy, called me up and asked me if I wanted to buy a car. And I said, I can't buy a car and stuff like that. And so he let me borrow. Turned out to be my old car that I sold back. I sold to him about 10 years prior. And so I borrowed that, wound up buying that from him. My nephew is running that car now. I went down to Pennsylvania this winter and I built a car from a 250 Micro Sprint with 400 Honda on it. And grabbed a little girl and paid for it.
What's your place tonight?
It was like 7 or something like that. I had carburetor issues. I did lead for a lap, but I wanted to seven.
Now you're the president of the club, right?
Yes, I am. Proud of
you. How many members do you have in the
club? 46 or 47, I believe, or something like that. We're running 12 to 18 cars every week in the 500 class. We're running 5 to 10 in the 600 class. Class get bigger. We tried to initiate a stock class this year to try to help get more 600s involved and not be as expensive.
Right. So what's the difference between the stock class and
the stock class has to run a stock fuel, where the modified class is actually running an alcohol based fuel.
Yeah. Well, I'm thinking more price range, you know. I mean,
it's just motors. It's with the stock class, you're more likely to be able to pull the motor right out of the bike and take it racing. When you're running a modified class, you're going to need an incentive to an engine builder and get something done. These guys are running fast out there.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You know, engine out of a bike is about a grand, 1500.
Yeah.
You get
get it built from there, it's probably another 5, 6, 7
yeah, exactly.
grand. So yeah, you're talking a big difference in price of cars, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Hopefully you can get the 600s up and running. Because obviously, if you get a lot of cars out there, you put on a really good show.
Yeah, it really is. And they're fast. They're the fastest cars on the racetrack. So it's really great and stuff like that. But we'll get them around there. The economy's turning back, and that's what's helping too. Racing's picking back up and stuff like that. So that's a big deal.
Price down a little bit. Get some of 500s to go up.
Yeah, well,
that's the biggest thing.
But what we did this year too is we allowed a 600 chassis with a 400s and 500s this year.
Yeah.
So now you can actually just buy a 600 frame, start off with the 400 or 500, and then you can progress without having the same frame. And that way there, it makes it so it's more affordable. You already know your car and stuff like that. So it's not like, all right, I want to run 500 this year to get my feet wet, and then I got to sell it and try to find a 600. You can do it all with one chassis now. And that's some of the things we're trying to do. Trying to improve on.
That's the way you want to take it to it. Want to get more people involved.
Oh, love to have more people. And it's such a fun, I mean, I had my whole family up in Florida up here tonight.
Yeah, oh, I met them.
Yeah. And great people and stuff like that. They absolutely loved it. And it was a good time. And that's what it's about. It's about being a family.
There's only one problem. The lady that was up there, I don't know how she's related, but she was talking about one of those late models.
Oh, yeah. That would be my daughter. That would be my daughter. Yeah. Bigger's better, you know?
I sit there as well. Are you supposed to go into mini sprints or something? Oh, no, we like these ones over here.
That would be my daughter, yep.
I sit there and says, there you go. Empty pockets, you'd be all set.
Yeah. But, no, they're great people. They flew up. My grandson graduated last night. Fortunately, we had a race schedule tonight that was pretty close to him, and they could come over and make that happen. And really proud to have him there, because that's what this club's about. This club's about family.
Oh, yeah.
It's about getting everybody together, sharing parts, working together and stuff like that. And that's the biggest thing right there.
Everybody's going to race every night. Have a good time.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
All right, thank you very much, sir, and you have a great night.
Yeah, you too. Take it easy. Okay, Jason McAllister down here at Legion Speedway. I'm here with Will and the whole family here. This is a family operation coming down here for this type of racing, mini sprint racing. Okay, Will, I'm going to start with you. Your dad here. What started you with this racing all the other? How did you start racing?
I started racing when I was about 7 years old, racing four wheels up at Sugar Hill Speedway in Wayne, New Hampshire, when Lenny West owned it, and raced up there for many years. And it's ice racing, and I didn't have any money to race anymore, so I just stopped racing. I just followed some of these guys around, and I think it was about 2 years ago, a friend of mine bought a car from somebody. The motor was not running. I pulled it all apart, pulled all the pine needles out of it, got that thing running, and next thing you know, I'm buying my own car, and here we are. We're racing here with the Granite State Mini Sprint Club, having a good time. And I put my son in the car this year, and he's trying to run for Rookie of the Year and Champion of the Year. And you know, everybody says you can't count your chickens before they hatch, but I think mine already hatched. We're doing all right, but we're having a lot of fun. And you know, the thing about this club is it's family orientated, and it's supposed to be family, fun, and friends. Everybody's supposed to get along, and we do. Everybody helps everybody out. It's a good time.
You're the spokesperson for this club. I'll tell
you. Yeah.
All right. All in one breath. Hey, Will. Okay. Another win tonight.
Yeah.
Obviously, we're smiling about that. That went according to plan.
Happy daddy.
Happy family all together.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously, they're all smiling about that.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, good night tonight. So, obviously, the plan is just to keep on running the way you're running, right?
Oh, yeah. Started 11th and ended up first. And just a pretty good track out there. So,
your other son in here. He's back a little bit. Bring him in a little bit. All right, this is the other son. This is not the son that races. Okay, what are you involved in this operation?
Pit hopper. I go around to every pit. Somebody
yeah, but you know what though?
I'm there. 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 I'm there
Gerard. What man. Not only your brother, but everybody else. Very good. We need more of you guys, that's for sure. Okay, we're going to bring your mom in. Mom's up next. Now, what do you do for the club?
Okay, so
the big question is, how does this work out in your family time? Because obviously this cuts down on the time. It doesn't cut down on the time with family. You're all here.
Right. So, this is what we enjoy.
This is what we do. This is what we've always done since the boys were little. 2.5 years old when we started riding a four-wheeler. And ever since then, every weekend we're out on four-wheelers, dirt bikes, doing something, motoring home.
More than family oriented, 100%.
This is our life. We love it.
And obviously this year we're smiling a lot more than we were last year.
Oh yeah.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Appreciate being with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.